through what math does my child need to get to by the end of high school? How do I make sure I'm meeting the state standards? And how do you teach math effectively to your children if you don't feel you are good at math? And what if your child is behind grade level in math? I'm going to answer all these questions and more in this video, which is all about teaching homeschool math for high schoolers, no matter what curriculum you are using. I'm Jenny Phillips, the founder of The Good and the Beautiful. Let's jump right into two of the most common questions we receive about homeschool math for high schoolers. Through what math does my child need to get to by the end of high school? And how do I make sure I'm meeting the state standards? So these are complex questions that don't have one single answer. State standards will help guide this decision. So it's important to know what your state requires if there are any requirements at all. You can look up this information through your state's Department of Education, and we also have a helpful link in the description below. Some states require a certain number of years of credits of high school math. Some require taking certain math courses. Some states have no requirements at all. So just know your state standards and have that in mind when considering high school courses. Students can follow different math tracks for high school courses. When deciding what math to take and when, consider your child's future goals, which often start to take shape in high school. If your child wants to pursue a math-related field, they will want to take additional math courses in high school. Alternatively, a student who doesn't intend to enter a math-heavy field may prefer not to take advanced math courses and only take what is required by the state or what they need to do well on college entrance tests like the ACT. Some math progression tracks are typical, meaning most students follow these tracks. Others are considered advanced or remedial, but there is no right or wrong decision. The choice is a personal one. But do consider future plans and your state's requirements. We actually have an amazing math tracks chart on our blog that shows different math track options your child can take in high school, depending on their circumstances. So check it out in the description below. Another question I'm often asked is, what math does my child need to take to prepare for the ACT or for college? What if they are not planning on going to college? So let's talk about those things. Most students take the ACT at the end of their junior year. Students need to have a familiarity with algebra and geometry. And all of the suggested tracks we have on our blog have students taking geometry by their junior year. So they should be ready for this test. Students looking to enter college will want to see what the college requires and what is required for their intended major. These discussions can start early in high school, so options can be researched. Even if a child does not know what they want to do after high school, they can still research options to have an idea of how to structure their high school math courses. And if students are not planning to go to college, they may or may not want to take math each year of high school. Some students may not plan to go to college, but still enjoy math and want to continue their studies. Another common question about homeschool math for high school is, what do I do if my child is behind? For example, we realized that my child wanted to take an advanced track for post-high school plans, but they are in Algebra 1 in ninth grade. Can they catch up? It is possible to catch up, but be sure this is what you and your child want to do, and then know that this plan can always be changed if it isn't working out. Students who are driven and motivated may be able to take two math courses in one school year. Some may also want to double up on lessons or continue their math studies in the summer. But just keep in mind that with homeschooling comes flexibility, and it is always important to keep the lines of communication open with your high school child and know that their overall health and well-being is more important than being in the right math course. I have seen too many overstressed and even depressed high school students who are being pushed too hard just for the sake of pushing for early college classes or overexcelling. It is truly not worth it. Let's go over one more question, which is, am I really qualified to teach math? This is a question a lot of parents have, and many parents feel that math is not their strong point or that they don't remember math. But it's interesting to note that studies have shown that despite the parents' level of education, homeschoolers tend to excel academically. Even though you may not have experience teaching math, a good curriculum that is specifically designed for homeschoolers will guide you and your children effectively through every lesson. However, in all honesty, when you get to the level of some high school math courses, it can exceed a parent's abilities or comfort level to teach. If you feel that way, you are not alone, but we have some suggestions. First, there is a plethora of high school math options out there to fit every need. There are often live classes held locally or online. Some people join their local high school for just math. Others take online math courses with recorded video lessons. Others hire a tutor. Others join with another family who has a specialty in math. Others do math with a co-op. and others get together with a family or two and hire a tutor together. Other children just read their math book and get it done without any videos or extra help needed. There are so many options. With some prayer and research, solutions can be found. You don't have to be the one to teach your child high school math, but you don't have to be intimidated about homeschooling a high schooler. So that is it for this video. Make sure to check out the other videos on our channel to learn more about our K-8 math program and for other how to homeschool videos. We are on a mission to make homeschooling effective and easy because we believe that homeschool has the potential to fundamentally and beautifully strengthen families and to change lives.